Okay.
I just Tommy, give
an introduction of what we're doing. We're casting.
Yes, it's episode 2 of High Cup. And Happy New Year's.
Happy New Year, everybody. Happy New Year. Past.
2020 here in what? Most of the world or all of it so far?
No, we're in 2019. I'm in 2019, so is Tommy. So, Stone, that's all
right, guys.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah,
We'll be casting this High Cup. I'm stoned as we've got Dave and Iron observing, and we'll be going into Quark versus Renegade X on Eternal Empire very shortly.
Yes, and here are some sound effects. Just some warnings, alarms. I like to do the challenger approaching. I'm trying to get like a you know those kaiju battle warning sounds. You ever seen Pacific Rim?
Yeah. We'll get around to that sort of stuff. But yeah, so this one, guys, is not actually a live match. This one is a replay from, was it yesterday or 2 days ago, Iron?
I believe it's a day ago.
All right, well, are we ready to get into it?
We are ready to get in. Let me just play the challenger approaching sound. And we'll start that. Oh, I have the Mortal Kombat round 1 fight.
Okay, so you got bottom left. Can I get the first one? In the upper right?
Sure. So you want to take right first, are you?
No, I thought we went left first. Do bottom left, yeah. You do
left first, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever's left.
That's you.
All right. In the bottom left, our blue Protoss. It is Quark.
In the upper right, sporting the yellow, whatever the hell on the tendrils, we have Renegade X from Team Risen, I believe, with the Cinder, with Rinsen. Their flamey flamer. They're a bunch of flamers in Risen, not to be offensive or anything, folks.
They're just on fire. They're fire clan.
They're on fire. They're fire, man.
Katjutsu.
That was the correct way to say that, I suppose.
The land of fire. The hail.
Okay.
Now, we saw some very interesting aggressive play from Quark yesterday, so I'd love to see what he's got in store for us today.
This tournament's been nothing but PvZ so far.
Yeah, we had 3 yesterday, and here we are again today.
I think it's all PvZs this time as well.
What's interesting about Quark is actually a Protoss and a Zerg, if I'm not mistaken. Which I
is this your friend Quark? This guy's from Alpha.
I haven't talked to him in a while, right? Yeah, he joined a clan that wasn't ours, or he wasn't one, but we enjoyed playing our game.
Okay.
He's been on my friends list, and recently we played, that's why I knew, other than the replay.
Renegade, we have played with him on lots of VTLs, I believe. He's the caster for Renegade. Seems like a really chill guy. Well,
It definitely gives a player a good edge if they have an understanding of another race, especially in a situation like this. It's a lot easier to be able to scout and understand what your opponent's doing if you have that understanding of that race.
Now, Quark has a double wall. He's got kind of a tester wall that's not a wall, but it's like intentional. You know what I mean? He scouted it out. But he sees spawning pool first. He didn't hard wall. He's like, well, he's going to do something more logical, I think. What do you guys think? What do you think Snow does? He's got, you see that? He's got a 4-unit wall.
No, he'll be what, Quark? I'm pretty sure he'll be packaging that up in momentarily. He'll pick his tech structure first, and then I believe he'll be finishing off that full wall, or not full wall, soft wall.
Yeah, it's very soft. He's got 2 units on each side, you see that? Yeah, and the center and the bottom. Alright, so the Zerg dropped his third.
Yeah, so we saw that Renegade X took his 100... wait, no, he didn't take his 100 gas for Metabolic Boost. Sorry, my mistake. He did not go for that, but he did pull his workers out of gas already. So, yeah, looks like we are going to be seeing perhaps some... Well, yeah, no early aggression here so far. Okay, the Adept in the natural gear going to get a couple of kills.
Oops.
He's doing the Adept Reaper.
I was doing weird camera hotkeys, don't mind me.
The Adept is not surrounded. Just not going to shade out of there. I think his focus was elsewhere at the time. He may have flipped back to his.
He was trying to attack this Overlord, I believe.
Meanwhile, Stonehenge hides his Twilight in the bottom left.
Ooh. And your favorite! Your favorite!
We're looking for a.
I skipped the robo, but I walked right by it myself in my view. Oh my good lord, guys. He's doing the.
Dave is excited.
But he's gonna scout it. It's already. There's gonna be spores. You watch spores.
Spores.
Yeah, well, we're gonna be seeing some sort of DT rush.
He's going to layer. Is he going to layer?
He has actually spotted it. It just comes down to whether he clicks on it. So we will be seeing some Dark Templar play into possible Archon drop here, guys.
Do you guys use camera hotkeys or no?
Myself, I typically just zoom and I use the scroll zoom and the insert and delete pan and file units.
I mean, when you play normally.
Myself, I don't. No.
How do you? I mean, I.
On the third. Let's see if Cork uses. There's spores everywhere.
Yeah, he's got a spore in each base. That's not the end of the world. I mean, it's good to get that damage. I mean, to really pick off a third hatchery can be game ending for the Zerg, but you can definitely still get some done with this Archon drop. We don't see anything on the side for Renegade X. He's got his Queens ready at the third
and
a bunch of Lings.
So let's look at the Zerg. Yeah, the Lings, but Renegade adapted. He was very adaptive to his play. He has a Roach Warren. He's teching up. He's going to layer tech almost completing. And we know what. I'll be honest here. Like, Quark is later than my DTs usually, like, at this point.
Yeah, it's a little bit light here.
Prism DT.
Only a tiny bit.
It is. I mean, like it should be 4:30, but I'm looking based around the same time. Ranking and stuff and how things
are. No, this is the double warp prism version. He's got DTs coming in from the south as
That's
well.
What I'm saying. I was mistaken.
Multi-pronged DTs.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. So this is almost like an M-canning 9 DT here.
Yeah, he can still make it work. Even if he's not afraid of that fucking one spore crawler, he's gonna be all right. You know, he can actually still drop in the bottom.
It's coming.
The natural.
Well, Renegade X only has one Overseer, and right now it is over at the third. So, those DTs kind of in the wrong spot. They're not wanting to hit from there.
Nobody can take
out. Snipe out the spore. Snipe out the
spore. A lot of drones going down there.
Lots of drones.
Worker kills.
Even with detection.
He could have killed the detection and then had more of an advantage.
Oh, here comes the spore again. Here comes the other prism.
Advantage then.
Tommy, are you showing the units killed, workers killed? That'd be a good time. And
it automatically showed.
Did you do control?
He's got game heart mod on. Oh, jumping on the spore right now. Spore is going to go down.
Here comes it back again.
I think Renegade X may have made a mistake at the game. He didn't actually go for early link speed either. Like, not early, just not.
No, yeah,
link
speed
would
have been huge.
It was very late link speed. That's why I think he made a mistake earlier on.
Do you see what Quark said that was actually genius, though he made some losses, is he targeted those drones after again.
Yeah.
33 drones have gone down. That's a lot.
Yeah, he's actually set the Zerg economy behind, which is huge for a Protoss. Like, that's like hero Protoss right there.
Let's see back home what's going on. Lots of zealots.
In quite a good position right now. Very
he's
good position.
More gates, but he's got Big Daddy Immortals out. He's got charge not even being researched, or it's being researched soon probably, but no charge.
I think
he's
that's a
zealots.
Mistake there to not have charge ready by now. I think he's forgotten it.
Yeah, he did. He link speed has been upgraded. The only upgrade from Protoss is
A little bit of
sentry.
Okay,
attempt at rebuttal, but.
See, usually you get your charge shortly after you have enough. After you warp in your first round of DTs. I mean, this build is a little bit different with the extra warp prism, so he may have forgotten it there. So you got the Observer coming out as well to assist the army with shutting down some of that creep.
What did he do with his advantage, do you think? In my opinion, he didn't focus on the detection first.
That's what I'm surprised, because he could have almost gotten a whole hatchery there had he have destroyed the detection, because there was only one overseer at the time. So I feel like you're right. He might have been able to actually take down an entire base there.
But he has done a lot of economic damage.
Clearing creeps.
The drones, he did a lot of stuff. Look at more DTs on the side. Oh no, there's DTs.
That's it. Zealots and DTs on the fourth. Denying that, the Zerg is in a very tough position right now.
Quark is doing great at confusing the hell out of his opponent. With more drops, more warpings. Oh, DT Archon.
Well, that's it. He's doing the right thing, you know? He's teching up at home. He's getting his upgrades. His charge is nearly done. His plus two is on the way.
But look at what happened. He also killed that Overlord on the side. So he's look at the max supply cap. He's got a superior army advantage.
That's it, and he doesn't have to take the fight right now because he is economically ahead. He doesn't have to fight.
And he has an upgrade advantage. He's ground weapons level 1, and he's approaching ground weapons level 2. Zerg.
So he's in a very good spot right now.
Yeah, he can really sit back
and keep teching up, and then he can just start, you know, start throwing some army in later, like to, you know, from hit from all angles. Because right now our Zerg play does not have enough to divide his army up.
I see a Hydra stand, but no Hydra has been made.
No Hydra.
Roads and Ravages on the left. Army is split right now. Fuel Mortal's going to go down. The Zerg player has a good concave here. This is not the right fight for Quark to be taking without utilizing those force fields.
He should have just pushed in, and he should have force sealed
it. But there's just too strong. Those Protoss Zealots too strong.
Those Zealots a little. The upgrade advantage there really took its place there for the Protoss.
Now he has to fight Hydras though. If he just force shielded those roaches down.
Not enough Hydras against all these Zealots.
I mean, look, we know that the Protoss is still ahead, but it still wasn't the best fight for him. He didn't necessarily have to take it like that.
Wait, what the hell? What?
See, right now he's half of his army is still backed up in the choke point. But yeah, we can expect to see GG called very soon. There's just not enough here for our Zerg player Renegade X.
Oh god, he took it down. Jeez. Quark on 3 base economy where he could have much
21 more workers dead.
He's pushing, he doesn't need to.
And GG called.
Renegade for the loss. Quark with from Team Alpha Beta, the victor 60, of this match.
60 probes going down for... Oh, sorry, 60 drones going down for Renegade X in that game. But yeah, that fight, it still wasn't the best fight for our Protoss player, I believe. But the sheer amount of Zealots there just tearing through the roaches, they had no chance with the Immortals in the back, pumping through them.
Would you guys call that a flawless victory or an awesome victory?
I think that was quite well executed. Only little things here and there that could have been improved on, but very nice victory for our Protoss player there.
Awesome victory.
I would say almost flawless because Well, it's pretty close because if you look at the units workers killed count, and if you look back and rewound, which we don't have to do, in the center of the map, there was a time that Quark with his multi-prong attack was very, I would call it flawless myself, as much as there may have been mistakes at certain engagements, he had the advantage and he knew it. The Overlord in the center of the map, he distracted it, making the Zerg to think that was his whole army or most of his army or his push, if you don't recall, Stone too.
Yeah, no, I know the one you're talking about.
Yeah, that was actually that was like 300 IQ play right there. Because in reality, he had his second war prism going. Yeah, exactly, because you're the other Protoss player here. The second war prism, I was just like, why is he making an Archon over there? I'm like, oh, he went for a multi-prong attack, or he made the multi-prong engage to gather the troops together. But the guy was suspecting it. Oh, it was just one push, you know? So it didn't matter.
Would you call that a fatality finish or brutality finish?
I'd say fatality finish.
Okay, fatality. Okay.
All right, let's move into game 2.
All right. So this was Quark going up 1-0. My Ferengi friend Quark.
Oh, did I play that game out of order? I
from
wonder.
Team Alpha Beta.
Hope I didn't. Get out of game, Dave.
Oh, shit. I'm the only one in game.
I don't know if I played game in order or not.
You guys
I'm not
are
sure.
Like, what are you talking about, Dave? And I was sitting there, it's like, oh, I didn't see you guys leave.
Well, now, it is round two, so.
Let's see what Renegade does. I still was a fan of the fact that Quark did what he did, but I didn't see the first DT drop. In hindsight, I think he had some mis-executions, but.
Yeah, there was a couple on both sides, a few little mistakes in their builds,
but going double was awesome. That was.
Oh, yeah, I love
that
play.
That was pretty badass.
That's it.
You
All done. Right.
You take it from the left, sir.
All right, in the upper left, currently up 1-0 in the series, our Protoss player, it is Quark.
And in the bottom right corner, we have from Team Risen, I believe, Renegade X, the man, the myth, the legend, who's probably going to have like double the amounts of spores in case of Dark Templar again earlier. Watch. Let's see. Or he's just going to hit him earlier. With... No?
So,
The only thing is, I don't know if I played the game in order. That's the only thing. Because they just sent it to them.
Yeah,
I don't know which game is the first game.
Well,
I need to ask them to name which game is the first game when they send me the replay.
Tell them to. You know what? We're going to come up with a naming convention. You guys got to name the. People aren't going to do it exactly, but like a file name convention, Iron.
Yeah.
So it'll, you know, we all know. We're all three of us are in the IT field. Come on.
Yep.
But they're. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So this time we've seen Gas first again for Renegade X for pull. So this time it'll be interesting to see if he utilizes that Gas. Because, yeah, I was a bit surprised to see him pull the drones off so early last round. And what do you think, Dave? Are we going to see more aggressive play out of Quark? He was very aggressive yesterday as well against Zerg.
Oh, we certainly will. Quark might even be doing the same thing again for opener, to be honest, from the looks of it.
Yeah. You know, Quark seems like he plays quite similar to the way I do in terms of the way he builds, or his builds, his scouting. This probe down here in the natural for Quark as well, just hanging around waiting to spot that drone moving out for the third to make sure he's not getting cheese or all in early. So that drone should be coming out soon for the third.
He does it, oh yeah.
Okay, so look at that. Can we have a shot of our Quark's natural here? We can see we've actually got a sentry first coming out for Quark. So this could be a similar build to yesterday, like a type of soul train push again with immortals and sentries.
Yeah, probably.
And there's your third drone heading out to build the third hatchery, and the probe gonna harass that and gonna block it from going down for now. These lings gonna push it away.
He delayed it. He delayed it.
Got a bit of a delay. I think he misclicked there. The drone was actually chasing the probe instead of the lings chasing it. So there you go. Stalker as well. Yeah, this build. See, Robo first. This looks like it's going to be an immortal sentry push. I don't think Renegade is going to... Oh, is he going to get the scout there?
Nope.
No, just misses the scout on the Robo there. Very little... Yeah, just missing it by only a matter of pixels, I think, though.
You know, I think that was next level play. Quark did that almost intentionally. It looked like he was going away, but I'm looking at Quark's vision. It was like he literally hesitated just to do a little waste of time and micro for
We've got
camera view.
Another scouting overlord coming into the main here. He is going to spot the robo, so he's going to see that. There's not too much of a giveaway at this stage. Although there is a lack of tech, so he may suspect, based on as well on the number of sentries, he can see that this is a type of early aggression.
Warp gate finishing up.
See, another thing I'd like to see from Renegade, I can't remember if it was Renegade yesterday or if it was another Zerg player in a PVZ. It'd be nice to see them leaving another overlord down here on the pervert pillar down here, so that we can spot. Oh, so he can spot the gas, because right now a Zerg player being able to see the natural for the Protoss would know that there's no gas taken right now, that this, it has to be a two base all in. Any Protoss player would have two gas in their natural by now if they were planning on expanding.
Now let me just make a point. It's 4 minutes and 30 seconds. The Hydra build, the 4 minute and 30 second DT thing. I gotta throw the Dave Test DT comment. The build that he just used. That's the time it's supposed to hit stone. Now you know why it's powerful. Look at Lair.
Oh, we see this little harass going on here in the main. Yeah. Ooh, just getting away. Just getting away with his gas units. Yeah, we saw him do this yesterday. He went down, picked off a queen, attacked the third, and then ran away. He'll come back with an immortal. He hasn't actually started his second immortal yet, though. Yesterday he did it with a second immortal. Maybe he's waiting for the minerals, which he has got enough now. Although it's a little bit slower on this one. I think he made a mistake there because he wasn't really expecting so much resistance in the main from the Zerg player. So second immortal being chrono boosted out right now. And it looks like as soon as that immortal is done, he's going to push out with another warp in of sentries and stalkers.
Well, I'd see in the structures aspect.
You know what's great about prisms is you don't need to go back and pick up more units if they die.
No. Well, you do for robos and, you know, Stargates, obviously.
But still, you can reinforce some stuff, continue to harass.
Yeah, you always got your gateway units. There's the classic double immortal push.
Yeah, this build is a little bit different to yesterday. He's modified it a bit. I'm not sure if this is because it was late. He has taken his third. The last time we saw this build, he didn't quite take the third until after moving out. But this time, yeah, going to go to the main with that double immortal and get a little bit of damage down. There's not much up there to protect the queen right now.
No, wait, why is this phoenix going there? He's distracting them to go towards the phoenix.
Yeah.
Double immortal.
Not sure why he's attacking the geyser though.
Yeah, taking a gas would be even worth it if that's all he gets out of it.
Yeah, I feel like he'd get a bit more value out of these immortals right now if he can get that queen before he picks up
the counter. Ooh. You know what I mean? He got
better safe than sorry, right?
Okay, there you go.
Expensive.
He's actually put down a Robo Bay and actually going for Colossus now because he spotted the Hydra Den with that scouting, the Hallucinated Phoenix. So he's going into Colossus tech now. Colossus are a very good unit against Hydras.
Yeah, and he's got his thermal lance upgrading too for the Colossus, which is going to be the push toward it, keeping up the hallucinations.
Yeah, so
when Colossus out,
because Quark didn't get the damage done that he was looking for with that that build originally that he was intending to go for. Like it definitely looked like it was an immortal sentry push, which turned out a little bit late, so he's declined on going for that. So it'll be interesting to see where he goes with this now. Because the supply is quite, there's quite a big gap in the supply right now. He's a little bit behind on army and workers. Unfortunately, for some reason, I get glitched in replays where I can't see the actual army and worker count.
Army count, I displayed it. 79 workers to 73 in favor of yellow.
Oh, he's at the
100 army to 66 army.
Yeah, okay. Oh, just saving that immortal there.
But these are Protoss units.
Not bad right now. Those force fields need to go down.
Ooh.
Oh, a little bit late there. The army getting right on top of the immortals and the Colossus.
He's gotta move out. He moved into it.
Just gets in range of the shield battery. Still going down though.
He moved in range of the corrosive bile though.
A little bit too much GPS from the Roach Ravager here. Eventually going to be cleaned up with a few Hydra reinforcements coming in. Miss Rally there. They're going to turn around and go home. Blink Micro actually catching them. They're not actually going to make it home.
The sad thing was, though...
No go home for you, Hydra.
Mr. Quark on the Protoss side was he actually engaged that Colossus right into the corrosive vial.
Yeah.
It was right on the target. Oof. But let's see what's Quark's on. Let's see here.
78 to 30 armor supplies now.
Five bases
now. 96.
I feel like the only problem there was Quark's reaction time. I feel if he had have gotten down those force fields and split the army in half or blocked them on the ramp, he definitely
could have lost the disruptor. The disruptor could have done a lot of damage.
The Stalkers cannot fight against Hydras.
Disruptor
coming
out
up here. Let's see how the shot goes.
Whoa, Kaboy!
Not a bad shot. He needs that high ground advantage right now. He should really go back up that ramp. I'm surprised to see.
Oh, he lost on disruptor.
Fight down there.
Oh,
Stalkers.
Spike micro. Spike micro, but still.
See, he actually has got the upgrade advantage here by one attack. But yeah, I think that blink micro is actually not something you see every day, Hydra's fighting against Blink Stalkers, is it?
What's the guy? Zealots down there? Alright.
Yeah, Warp Prism down there, down the south, down at the 6 o'clock base.
And the Zerg is going to push with Roach Hydra up top. Let's see.
He's going to be distracted and not be able to deal with this prism
he's
right here.
All those Stalkers need to get out of there. He's going to lose them. There's a huge concave of Roaches and Hydras on them at the moment. Okay, we got
Boom!
More.
Save the war prism!
Disruptors and Colossus on the way.
Another one.
Protoss player. Oh, unfortunately, not the hit that he was looking for. This is starting to tip largely in favor of our Zerg player right now. Unfortunately, our Protoss player has not been replacing that those large, expensive units.
He just wants that cooldown to be finished on his disruption cover. Oh, he's got
double
no
disruption!
Good,
we got one.
That was
only one. This one should hit! Got one.
That wasn't that good either. He just took like one out.
Well, Colossus almost out is definitely going to help keep those Hydras back.
Look at those queens. They can see the. I'm going to envision the Zerg. They can't see the War Prism, but they know it's there. He's got all his queens rallied right to that. Fucking
yeah.
They're just going to take.
Oh, we got DT's heading in now. DT's going to walk straight through this Hydra army, just running along with them.
La 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 la.
Everyone just walks by each other.
At least, or no, he's going right in.
Where are they rallied to? Same spot, or
guys? I think this was game two. I have a feeling I think this was game one because.
Yeah, I think it's game one.
He saw that because he made overseers right then. I think he saw that.
Yeah, he must have. We've already got corruptors on the way out, so it looks like our Zerg
slapping it down to space,
preparing to go into Broodlords already. We've got the Great Aspirer,
22 drones.
Some very good economic damage being done here by our Protoss player, but the question is, will it be enough?
We got a couple of disruptors, that might be enough.
Got a lot of drones going down in the north, the top right corner as well here, but
this one should be big one! That's a... don't lose it.
Colossus about to spawn out here.
Some zealots fighting over here.
Hydras.
He actually took out a lot of drones in the main base too, guys.
63 drones going down right now for the Zerg.
Yeah, he killed them in the main base as well.
Has our Protoss player turned this around?
Oh yeah.
64. All those DTs.
Look at the economy right now. He has almost no mineral income. He cannot rebuild any of his army. What is out right now? He's got Broodlords, but as soon as those
Broodlords
go down, Broodlords,
and they got blinks, so.
Blink Stalkers will easily kill Broodlords when there is nothing on the ground to protect them. Yeah,
and he realized that.
We might expect to be able to see GG called here because the mineral income is just not here for our Zerg player. There is DTs at the fourth, and there it is, our Protoss player turning the game around and taking a 2-0 victory after being quite far down in the game. That was an amazing comeback.
Quark was definitely. Quark is 3,800, Renegade's like 42, so that was an upset.
Yeah, no, I think that was definitely Renegade X's game. to lose there. He was ahead. I think, unfortunately, he did neglect his bases. He didn't have the detection. He really needed to pay more attention to his mineral lines and keep them safe from these DTs. They got about 65 kills.
I think
whilst,
we watched.
Renegade was on the other side of the map.
I think we, yeah, exactly. While you were looking up at the top, Quark actually had one Dark Templar going and he was microwaving it, it appeared, because he was targeting workers. He almost killed the, at first he wasn't, he almost killed one of the queens that were facing the spot where the war prism was. And then he went and was target firing. He like must have set rally points on attack for each drone in the main base. Even though it was a little bit of economy, it was over mined.
That was a bit of a combo finisher, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was
like a combo.
DT, that was like a
hold off, and then follow up.
That was a brutality right there.
You think that was a brutality?
Oh yeah, because
what about Ultra combo? You ever play Killer Instinct?
Oh yeah.
Ultra.
Killer Instinct was the shit, man.
I think it's a combo. That was more of a combo.
Certainly Quark had his shaky ground for sure, but he had good engages all around and supports. I think
I feel like Quark's build sort of went off track when he originally almost lost his sentries and warp prism in the main of our Zerg very near the start of the game. I think that was his little off throw point. All right, what do we have up next?
Iron, should we start another one for the next?
Start another one? Why?
Why not? Then we can know which replay it is and stuff. Or you want to just
no? I'm doing it as like a few, you know, as episodic. So we do a few, you know, series per episode. It's the format. It's the format here.
Right.
Okay. Let me switch back.
I think we should just do High Cup as a thing. Like we got to talk to Hydra about that High Cup. Season, whatever, and the next season we can plan and have so you're not doing as much on that as you have to. You know what I mean?
Okay, now
I will help with that.
Now it is time for the episode. This episode, I call it Enter the Kyujin, which is another player. Anyone watch Attack on Titan?
I think you should call it the House of Quark.
House of
Deep
Quark.
Space Nine episode. The guy is Quark.
Perhaps.
That's what his name's from, the House of Quark.
I can name them both. Next up, we have the Kyujin versus Extinct Sea.
Oh.
All right, well, let's get right into it.
In this one, we have the game names named correctly. So, I do have those games. Okay.
I'm not gonna lie, guys. That just gave me a bit of a chub.
A what?
It gave me a little bit of a chub right there. I get a little excited, you know.
You're
watching Templar going at, winning against the Zerg two times in a row is just.
You're a fan.
You're a fan.
Can we reattempt that lobby?
You're a fan of his work.
Yeah, that's you know.
Got it. Anytime anyone goes DT, Dave is like, this is gonna be a good game.
I've got some kind of problem.
Okay. You want to log off and log back in? Log off and log back in.
No, just... Yeah, I am.
Maybe.
Yeah, sorry, guys. A little bit of technical difficulty here right now.
Technical difficulty. Okay. It's all right. I'll just play some more sound effects.
Yeah. Tommy, you're just getting prepared for your next job. Did you turn it off? Did you turn it back on? I know the feeling, so don't feel bad, man. It's just, oof. It's the nature of the beast.
Play some warning alarms.
You can be straight and pretend that never happens, but he's got to deal with that too. He's just trying to.
I want like a.
Is better embellishments to it.
I want like a GIF overlay where like a metal door, like a shaft door, like a spaceship shaft door opens. Like warning, shaft door opens to space. You know.
Let's go for it.
What I'm talking about.
I'm back in.
Mm-hmm.
All right, invite him back.
You turned off the. High Cup thing on the stream.
You mean the splash screen?
Yeah, you turned that off.
Oh yeah, no, because I thought we were getting into a game.
Tommy, do you have that stuff on hotkeys by any chance?
I don't, I need to work on my hotkeys.
I can help you with that after, but definitely. Use Streamlabs. That's the problem. OBS is not hard. I can probably help you on that. Yeah, let's see. So we got
Exo Extinct versus Kaioshin
from the Pig 2 clan.
Pig, yeah, it's one of Pig's clans. I'm trying to remember if I played against Scott in the ladder before. I may have. All right, we ready to get into this?
We totally are, right after this sound effect.
I believe I played Exo Extinct before, honestly.
Yeah, I think I have too.
I think that's somebody we probably both hit. Now I'm facing the platinum guys more. Oof. What a weird feeling, man. I think I got hit by a freight train of masters. Not ready for that yet.
Alrighty then. In the upper left, our yellow Zerg from the Pig Clan, it is Exo Extinct.
In the bottom right, we have our orange Protoss, the Kyojin from Ken Alpazai.
Do you think we should start restricting them to red and blue?
Perhaps.
I'm not having enough of these colors, to be honest. We're getting turquoise, we're getting orange, we're getting Jenna. All right.
Suicide
now,
red.
I was so hoping to see a Ford myself, but
yeah, we saw a couple of cannon rushes yesterday. They were a little bit unsuccessful. It was interesting to see. There's a number of different types of cannon rushes you can do on this map. There's a good macro one. There's a couple of two pylon spots. There's a high ground pylon wall off. There's a number of things you can do. This is one of my favorite maps to play against Zergon as a Protoss player.
And Mr. Extinct seems to be delaying. Oh, yep. Yeah, he did it more delayed, so there's no early aggression from the Zerg player. Or super early, I should say.
Yeah, no super early, but it looks expect to see a likelihood of early Ling speed being gassed before pull.
I've been told that Kyojin is a Protoss. I've been told Kyojin's a very cheeky player. Let's see what they mean by that.
Let's see what he can come up with for us, hey?
From Hydra himself.
No, that means he's going to have some interesting stuff.
Excited to see that then, yeah, absolutely.
That means I saw he was Protoss, I was assuming he was somebody that Hydra likes. And that means he must have something interesting he does.
Kcal said the same thing. Unorthodox. Yeah, cheeky style, so I've been told.
He's gotta be pretty good.
Okay, well, you can see that our Zerg player has not actually the drones out of gas up. So we may actually some aggression here, some possibly, what are we looking at? Maybe a three base aggression.
Aggression.
Or even possibly two base. Well, he's going up to the second gas already.
Oh, look at the Protoss player, Zujin, taking some
Twilight minerals. First. So we could be looking at early aggression from both sides here. Okay, Depp going to get the scout. Oh, not quite going to make it up into the back of the main, though, unless he finishes that shade. Oh, no, he would not. He did not spot that Roach Warren going down.
That's funny. He just been scouting and stole some minerals from his third. That's funny.
Has he scouted that third location yet? No, he knows now there's no third. So at this stage, he should 100% know that something is up and that the Zerg player is definitely trying to pull the wool over his eyes here. It looks like it is going to be a two base Roach attack at this stage.
XTC himself is a notable player. He played in lots of qualifier tournaments in Philippines as well.
Okay, so you see, can we get a shot of the Protoss main here? We can actually see that we've got still only the Twilight, Robo finishing it up, and I mistook something.
He can't hold this. Like,
no, he can't. He doesn't know it's coming. Sorry, my mistake. I thought I saw three gates.
I thought it was a Nexus. It was zoomed in. Oh,
It's so huge.
He can't hold this.
I was like, what the fuck?
He's using a nexus to his face blocking.
Cybercore gonna go down. Now he needs to drop another cybercore as soon as possible.
Ooh, things are in.
Rookgate just finishing in time.
Oh, he's trying to snipe
down
the sentry. So no more.
He should pull the fucking pearls for those flings. Oh god.
Okay, that immortal has the potential to do some damage here.
Yeah, but the legs.
It's not. Oh, it's not going to get to the shield button. The boys have been pulled. They're going to have to help reinforce this immortal here. Probes fighting on the front line. Immortal dealing a lot of damage.
This should be holding. He's in this weird stuckish position.
Oh, he is going to hold this, but at what cost though?
Did he lose much? I don't think he lost much.
No, you see,
he lost a cybernetic.
Oh, look at that.
Now let's start looking at this right now. So. Think about this. Right now, our Protoss player
is actually...
Our Protoss player is in actually not a bad spot right now.
No, he's
during
in a great
that,
spot. There's no detection. Look at...
During all that time, ExoXync was floating a lot of minerals and did not make a third. There was quite a number of drones oversaturated on the natural.
But he was...
We should rename this episode Dark Templars Everywhere. Dark Shrines Everywhere.
Yeah, you should, because, but the key thing is he got a double immortal to be safe for roaches, but Stone, he could have, if he had that warp prism out, he could have beat the freaking layer, look it. He could have just when it came out, he could have, but it's still...
Yeah, no, I'm with you on that, because there's no, ExoSync still has no army, he only has the Queen defending him right now, although he has just dropped down a bunch of Spore Crawlers, he has seen the move out with his Overlord.
But look, the Overlord scouting the Dark Shrine right now.
Yep, so are we gonna see Spore? I don't think he's actually spotted it with his own eyes though, because look at all these Spores going down, his Overlord spotted what he thought was a move out, or actually is a move out now, but he still has no detection.
It's Overseer being
DTs are just about to arrive. Here we go. And there is DT's arriving in the main, DT's arriving in the natural. There is no detection here at all.
Ooh, Zealot, rush.
I'm killing the drone.
An immortal.
That's what I was gonna say, he's got.
No, he got the Overseer. Once they have the layer, that makes sense.
I was gonna say, the Overseer's out. He needs to target down these drones with these DTs.
Those DTs were a distraction.
Well, they did, yeah.
But see, even that is a lot of damage to our Zerg to be back on two bases in matchup, you know, with our Protoss player. Zerg always wants to have that base lead over both Terran and Protoss.
No, but the thing is, he didn't take any gas, he didn't expand. Our Protoss player is very committed to this push.
Yeah, he wants to end the game right now.
But
yeah, it's gonna...
Oh, he's going to drop DTs back there. He's trying
to. Now, Archon definitely doing well dealing with the wings.
No, he's
did not move out of the way of those boils. Those boils could really be a huge problem for our Protoss player.
All right, just pick him up and drop him. He should just pick up and drop or something. I think. Oh, shit.
Six drones has died recently.
See, now, what do you think, David? This point, I guess it's hard to say. I feel like the Zerg player should have been going for maybe a macro hatch whilst he was stuck in his base.
Macro hatches.
But he's out of, okay.
I'd rather do ninja hatch maybe.
So I'm not sure if you guys noticed that, but the DTs actually killed all the workers in gas. So if you take a look right now, there's 1100 minerals for Zerg and only 11 gas. So he's forgotten to put his workers back in, and he was not able to produce anything there.
Yeah.
Now you already know what I'm going to ask. Would you call that a awesome victory or a flawless victory?
I would say that was a flawless victory simply because he held the two-base roach push when he wasn't set up for it.
What about you, Stone?
In a very interesting way, but at the same time, I think that was a...
I don't think it was because I don't think he utilized his scouting information as much.
Can I have a third option for you?
I was off.
What's that?
Fatality, brutality, what else?
No, I was going to say, there's another one.
What else you got?
I would call that one the Protoss player should say. GG.
Oh yeah, we need to turn that to a soundboard.
Yeah, we need to get him to sample it when he says it in his full on, when he's excited, when he has a few beers in him in the morning or something. Smart Asian guys. GG.
I'm going to go with a false victory because he held that really well when they, that first aggression.
That was, I mean, Stone.
He lost a cybernetic course, but.
I thought it was over after that, and he stayed on two. On top of it, he could have done that aggression with. Expand. He should have taken.
Yeah, what? That's what I was gonna say. It was a very strange two base push. Usually, I would have thought you'd have more in the push, or you would take a third at the same time and.
But that's a
more.
Reminder for both of us as Protoss players. This is why I'm saying it's flawless. Because why I've been losing too. I forget the beauty of a two base build and the power of Protoss on two bases. Look at the time.
But see, it's not always about. Third hatchery. I mean, often you can. There's a lot of value in leaving the probe in the base to wait for. We all know that our gas geyser starts with 2250, right? So it's a good idea to leave your probe in the main of the Zerg until that geyser goes down to 2150, and from there you can. The tell is if they keep mining gas, you know that there's going to be some kind of aggressive push or gas heavy tech coming.
Now on that one, I would say where you can see the unorthodox mention from KKL and Hydra, in my opinion, from how he stayed on the two bases, he stopped probing up. If you notice, he stopped building workers.
He was looking to
maximizing his economy on what it was. With what he had, he saw the advantage, and he used some smart play to win. I like that guy's play. That sometimes you have to do that, and it's easy to forget.
Well, see, that build's not that bad that he went for, because it looked like that kind of build you can get a Warp Prism, two Immortals, and a handful of Charge Lots out by around about 5 o'clock, roughly.
And have Dark Templar behind it.
Well, yeah, if you want that to be a follow-up, then yeah, sure. If you can get that early Immortal out, it's definitely not a bad build because, yeah, those roaches are just not getting in when there's an Immortal there and a shield battery.
He was behind, so he Dark Shrine. That was my point. That's why I say that was flawless from his, not from his execution, but from his response.
I'm going to give him a Kyujin roar and a flawless victory. There we go.
Alright, let's move into game two, guys.
Alright.
Flawless. Are we ready? Victory.
Yes.
Sure. Then I need to take a break.
You're gonna take a break?
Yeah, sure. Well, how many more have we got? We got one more series after.
We got another series after this series.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm doing this one. I gotta take a break.
We'll have a quick intermission between this one and the next one. I'll go to see as well for something, and then I'll be back and I'll let you know. But let's get into game two of Exo Extinct versus the Kyojin.
Okay. How long are both of your breaks going to be?
I'm
not sure yet. Okay. Not long.
I can be quick. Just
do like a 5 minute. Just put a little timer on the screen or something like that when we're ready.
I don't know how to do the timer thing.
We'll figure it out. Or
you need to edit it out. No, I can help you out with that, Tommy.
Alrighty then. In the upper left, our Protoss player currently up 1-0. It is the Kyojin.
And at the bottom right, our Pig Clan Zergy McZerg, who's hopefully going to do something a little different. We have. Exo extinct.
Yeah, we had to figure this one out a couple weeks. But yeah, so I would say that this map is a little more favored towards a Zerg player. It is quite open. It is quite large. So yes, it will be definitely interesting to see what a Zerg player is going to go for in this round. Oh, we got a cannon rush coming up. Look at this forge first. The little two pile of Warloff here. He's going to use a gateway to seal off a cannon behind that. And at this stage, is the Overlord going to... Oh no, he's cancelled it. He's going for the high ground. That is... that's very clever because the Overlord has not come back to scout this. I like this. But he should have seen that second probe coming in. You see two probes as a Zerg player, you know straight away this has to be a cannon rush. Assuming he's been checking his mini-map. Here we go, the high ground wall off his favourite cannon rushes, or types of cannon rush anyway. Seen Parting do this one a number of times. Oh, he didn't cancel the pylons! Okay. He can't get into the main now.
That drone. Good, he is.
But the only thing is, he can't get into the main. I think that's a mistake,
no,
then.
He
should
drop a cannon. He should have dropped a cannon before in the top. He's been fine. The Zerglings couldn't attack, even one by the choke point of the. He should have done it closer in range to the pylons.
Yeah. Okay, well, Cogogen has taken double gas here, so we may expect to be able to see a robo coming down eventually. He still is late on the site core. It hasn't been placed down yet, which is very surprising. Just going down now, and then quite possibly the robo afterwards. Am I missing this guy? I must have made a huge mistake earlier.
This is amazing. I like this. I need to.
I think. Sorry, my mistake, guys. This. So there was a mistake with the pylons not being cancelled, but there was another probe up in the main. Did you notice that?
Yeah, I did notice that. That's why I always been worried about it.
Sorry, you should have told me that earlier. That confused the hell out of me.
I was confused by what you were saying, because I'm like, what do you mean? Like, I, honestly,
no,
I
sorry, I
can, probe there. He should
I completely
have
missed
the pylon.
That.
The Overlord is still there, but he could have dropped the pylon and got him to cancel.
You know, I completely missed that one. Roach Warren just finishing up now, so there will be a few roaches popping out shortly.
Well, he's got the advantage, but let's see here. I think one mistake could have been made while on that second hatch being built. The probe did some damage, but he could have dropped the pylon, got him to cancel it, which would have cost him 75 and chased the probe.
Well, yeah, usually you cancel two of those pylons on the high ground, then your probe goes and starts the cannons. Oh, see, the only problem is this Stalker is using up a lot of the shield battery energy right now.
Oh, shit, the Stalker, move it. Oh, God. Oh, shit.
All right. First Immortal about to be started. You know, he was forced to start
a
second Stalker there.
Rush,
now, tell me something, Dave. Is this Immortal going to be walled in? I have a feeling he's going to be stuck.
Possibly.
I think
Stalker getting very close to death.
I think he is just where his rally point is. It should be fine.
Yeah, this is going to be, be very sad for us all, I think, if this Immortal does not get out of that section there. Oh, it's lucky.
Yeah, it should be fine.
Okay, that Immortal going to be very hard to stop now. These queens.
I wasn't sure which direction it was going to go, to be honest, but.
Yeah, these queens and these Ravagers very
good
right now.
I was just worried about the micro on that. That was good.
Yeah, no, I don't think there's much chance in. Yeah, okay, we see GG is called.
Exo Stink 1.
Going up 2-0 on our Zerg player. I quite enjoyed that. I like how he went for the original cannon rush at the. Between the natural and the third. And then he actually changed up. He said, well, you know what? The Overlord can't see up here. The Overlord's over there, so I'm going to rebuild it here. I really enjoyed that one.
That's a pretty flawless, right?
Yeah, that was pretty flawless. That was
apart from walling himself
there is
down.
Picky.
Yeah, really picky, but he handled it.
He could have got him to cancel if he wanted to be really cheeky. He could have got him to cancel his second hatch too, and then chase the guy down, or just got him to cancel the second hatch, cancel his pylon, losing 25. The Zerg would have lost 75 minerals. As we know from our proxy hatch spawning pools, Tommy.
Would you say that's a fatality?
Hey,
I would say that's a brutality. He
fired. You didn't remove the splash screen for that whole game.
Are you serious? God
yep.
Damn it. God damn it.
I wasn't watching the stream too. My apologies.
Yeah, that's why I don't like.
Anyway,
yeah, that's why I don't like.
Going to.
Yeah, we'll just redo that real quick.
A short break, guys.
Yeah. It was really short anyways. It was a really short game, so we can just recast it real quick.
So this is High Cup Season 1, Episode 1?
2. Damn it.
Yeah.
Always
wait, Episode 2? Or Season 2, Episode 2.
Yeah, guys, I'm heading into a short break now.
What the hell? Somebody's Facebook calling me. Why is this guy? I don't even know that guy.
But yeah, Iron will be back shortly, yeah?
5 minute intermission.
Yep. Something like that, sure.
Sorry for
we'll
the
be back soon, guys.
There. Yeah.
All right, guys.
Hi, got a small favor to ask of you. Please add your...
the drone away to the third to check where that drone is actually going to go and rebuild the hatchery. First, Cannon going to go down here in the main, and spawning pool just finishing up before our Zerg. Also, take note here what he's done. The Zerg player's actually taken his second gas and actually hasn't put any works in it yet. I think he wanted to just secure it to start with. Okay, they're going in there now, but he wanted to secure that gas because if a Protoss player steals your gas when you're being cannon rushed, it is not a good thing at all for the Zerg. They just cannot produce the Rotors and Ravagers they need to try and break through. That cannon gonna go to work on this pylon here to try and to get back to be able to open up the access again for the second probe to be able to get up if he needs to.
The Spinecrawler kind of helping his cause there.
Well, that's it, helping him out. It's like, thanks, bro.
Thanks for the poke.
All right, Robo going to be the choice here of tech. Expect to see a few batteries and immortals coming out soon. Unfortunately, Iron, I can't actually follow your camera for some reason when I could yesterday. I don't know what's changed. What a pain.
Well, I'm just focusing on...
If you take a look at the third up here right now, have a look at the third. This probe is working away at the base here, already taking about.
You'll take it out eventually.
Almost a third of its health away. All right, first Sogger comes out, going to put a little bit of pressure on the Queen on the spine here. Shield battery going to keep it alive for now, but draining a lot of that shield energy before the Immortals come out. Another battery finishing up with another two on the way. Robo finishing. Another Stalker on the way out to come here and assist the one on its own. One of the Ravagers and the Spine taking a little bit of a bruising from the Stalkers and the Cannons. The Bile's not quite going to be enough to take down the Cannons at this stage. Still quite a bit of shield battery energy left. One Stalker going down and the Spine also just being finished off by the second Stalker. Alright, Kaijin dropping another pylon as well to try and expand his wall of cannons and batteries down to the bottom left there. First I'm all about to pop, only just going to make it out of there on its rally point. Looks like it was almost going to get stuck. Alright, now these Ravagers are very, very bruised right now. This wall is going to take them out quite easy without any contest.
One shot them in.
Just narrowly getting away from those Biles, one cannon going to go down. But yeah, they simply cannot fight this, and GG is called.
Yes.
Just give me probably just 1 or 2 minutes before we jump into the next one. I'll be right back.
Don't worry, I'll play sound effects. I would say that is a brutality. Alright, and let's see what we got next here. It's the Kyujin again versus DRF Dive. Let's pull that up here. Kyujin versus Dive, game one. We've got a PvP Protoss versus Protoss. Who is the better Protoss cheeser? What other sound effects do I have? That's all, I gotta get more sound effects. And we'll start there momentarily. First map is going to be Eternal Empire. Mm-hmm. What have we so far in the bracket?
Alrighty then, I'm back with you.
Okay, you're back. Sweet. Okay, we have more Kyujin. Kyujin versus DRF Dive.
Dive? Oh, PvP. Okay, I got a problem here again. This is what happened this time. Let me quickly just restart this, and we will be right into our PvP. You haven't actually had a PvP yet, so this will be interesting to see.
It's all been ZVPs, right? I think all of the matches have been PvP.
It's all been PvZ.
We haven't seen one Terran in this tournament yet. Shadows.
Okay, sorry, it's starting. No, sorry, guys, my
I don't know, do we have any Terrans? Rendezvous is a Terran, I believe.
You keep getting rid of the splash screen.
I didn't? Okay. Now I'm so worried about it putting on. I'm just gonna keep it on for now. I'm constantly worried about it. Like, I think I'm just gonna put
I'll remind you.
Like, if I don't have a reminder, I'm just gonna put it at the beginning, at the end. I'm not gonna put it in the middle.
So just keep it on for now.
Yeah, I'm just gonna keep. Okay.
And then I'll tell you when we get into game.
Alright.
Sorry.
So embarrassing. So embarrassing.
Oh my god, I'm having connectivity problems as well. Come on, Blizzard, give me a break.
Yeah, I need to learn all the shortcuts to OBS.
No, you are. You make your own shortcuts.
I want to change. How do they have shortcuts for my.
You can go, because. Every time you create a source or whatever, you then go to settings and then you go hotkeys and all your sources pop up in hotkeys and you change everything in there. Also, so you might have a hotkey that's for like start of game, one for end of game. So it switches everything around, puts the splash screen up and all sorts of things.
Can this thing also do sound effects? Like, can I record sound effects and put it on the button?
I believe so. I don't know what's going on right now, but I...
Into the game and log back in, maybe?
No, I did. I can't even connect, like, to the server in-game.
Try exiting game completely and logging back in?
No, I did.
Okay.
I'm just gonna restart Battle.net.
No worries.
What a pain. Jeez, Blizzard, what are you doing to me?
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like they're... StarCraft is like buggier and buggier every time they patch it.
Oh, no, I think I know what it might be. I think I've had trouble before with Discord being inside of a call as opposed to being in a channel.
Okay. We can try leaving this call.
Leave the call chat.
Okay. All right, we'll leave the call. Where did he go? Where did he go? What channel are you on? You back?
Try again now.
Okay. Cool. I'll put it back on the scene.
Let's open it back up. Let's get the back in the game here. Alright, we're going better. Alright, we have Dive versus the Kaiogen.
Dive versus
Let's get right into it.
Let's do it.
Alright, splash screen.
Okay, I already turned that off. So worried about that. Right, Eternal Empire LE.
Alrighty then, in the bottom left of Eternal Empire, our yellow Protoss from the Elgen clan, it is Dive.
And in the top right, we have the Kyogen of Alpha XI as the orange Protoss.
Sorry, my phone started ringing.
Your phone started ringing?
Yeah, that's what that noise was, if you could hear that. Alright, PvP, home of the crazy play. I would love to see some proxies or something, just something aggressive. That's what PvP is all about.
Okay.
There's not a lot we can see straight away to PvP. Most openers are quite standard. It's just it forks off after your Cybercore finishes, so we've got Dive going for the scout here. Kaiogen opting for that later scout off the both gateways.
Are you able to follow my cameras now?
No. Alright, here we go. Kaiogen searching around. Now the question is he looking for a proxy or is he looking to proxy?
I feel like I'm looking for a proxy.
Well, he's stopping here. It's okay, it's gonna
okay,
go all the way
never
around.
Mind.
The question is what will it be? This far away in proximity, it's hard to say, I mean, it could be a
it's like a faint proxy or
obviously,
not.
Obviously it's only two things it's usually gonna be. Well yeah, it'd be Robo Robo or Stargate, but usually the Tell will be in his first units. Alright, Cybercore's both finishing up for both plays here. Okay, Twilight Council proxied. Okay, so to me that looks like we're going to be seeing some DT play.
Hiding those Twilight Councils. Very Dave. I think Dave would be really happy if we
see
it.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking. Dave would love to see this. Alright, so Dive having a quick look around. He's actually searching for proxies on the map. Now, where is this probe rally? No, it's not actually going to scout the proxy. Alright, so Stalkers on their way out, just popping now for Kaiogen and Adepts coming out for Dive. So Dive's going to be looking for a little bit of early economic damage and then looking to expand. So his tech choice has gone for the Stargate. So if we do see some TTs here, he's really going to need some detection.
Confident.
And
oh, yep, DT it is.
DT shrine goes down.
After finding nothing, he decided to expand. Wrong move.
Oh, this could be tough. Now, it depends what his choice is. He's going for an Oracle, but he's currently actually supply blocked quite hard at the moment. Pylon just going down. Oh, those Adepts. Oh, okay, shield battery nicely placed just in time. Those Adepts going to be pushed back by these Stalkers. They're not going to get the damage they were looking for right at this moment. And just going to get one of those Adepts away. Stalkers on the hunt. Now, look at this. We've got Kaiogen proxying a second time a little bit closer with a gateway.
Ooh.
Very interesting. It's a double proxy. I love seeing multiple proxies. PvP, it's
this is
a
very,
very dense, interesting
bro.
Matchup. Oh! That, the timing on that pylon drop, very well. You know, very good timing there.
Oh, I missed it, unfortunately.
That's all right. Well, sorry. Kaiogen just got the shield battery down before the Adept was able to shade in. Over in the natural here, these two Adepts. Looking, to clean up that, Stalker's looking to clean up that Adept. Alright, first DT is out, but where is it being rallied to? And there is no detection here. There's an Oracle and an Observer on the way. So I think the lack of units or aggression may be the tell here for our yellow Protoss dot. DT showing up the front door here. That Oracle has arrived and the Observer has come out. It's going to be a little bit of economic damage because he doesn't know that there's one in his main as well. He's going to lose a lot of that mineral line. Probes. 11 going down so far. DT in the main 12. As well, working on that shield battery. It is going to be cleaned up eventually, but that is
literally the Dave Tester build.
A bit of economic damage. 17 probes going down. He's still in the natural. Hacking away at that Nexus. Sorry, I'm just still going more. Blank on everything I'm trying to say here.
Is DT still going to work? Very bad position right now. Not enough observers to go around, I guess. Or is there?
Yeah, well, but he has the Oracle. I'm surprised he didn't use that for a revelation.
Uh-huh.
Well, he's got two Oracles and they both have... Oh, sorry, one of them has enough for a revelation, I believe. These DTs doing a lot of damage to Dive with 23 workers going down. Dive needs to get some of his own, some economic damage done of his own right now. But there's a shield battery in the main of Kyogen, and a lot of stalkers in the natural getting walked in as well as protection from any oracles. Okay, the oracles come across now. With two oracles, they do have enough energy or, let's say, DPS to out-health shield batteries if they are attacking in sync.
Here we go.
But there's a lot of stalkers here to push them away. They're going to get a couple of kills here. Two, three, zap, four.
Zap, zap,
six,
zap, zap.
Six kills, seven kills. Not bad.
Not bad, but
he is going to lose at least one oracle. Point. And the second one, not going to make it out of there.
Does not make it out of there.
Not quite going to make it. So, yeah, that's only... probes going down
versus
the 23 probes earlier. Dive finding himself in quite a tough position at the moment. He doesn't have a lot of army. He's playing against against Archons, Charge Lords, and a large army of Stalkers now. We also have Charge for Kyogen. There's simply not enough here. Dive cannot defend this.
Nope. This is... pretty over.
I think we can see GG expected to be called. Yep, and GG. Nice game right there.
That was.
And yeah, so I got a couple of things happening at the moment. Just I'll give you another minute or two just before we jump into the next game.
I guess I will play some sound effects. A Titan roll is deserved for that.
Fatality.
And we have round two coming for y'all.
Round two, fight.
So we'll see these continue this Kyogen onslaught here. He has been unstoppable so far in the last three matches. Who will stop the Kyogen? We will find out. Or he might just sweep through this whole tournament.
Are we ready to get into game two here?
Oh, yes. Put it back on the scene. All right, game two.
Is the overlay off?
Overlay off. It'd be nice if I can take a screenshot of the bracket and show it like in between matches or at the end or something like that. That'd be really nice.
Oh, you could do that for sure. Alrighty then. Okay, Ephemerin, so in the upper left, currently down 1-0 our yellow Protoss from Legion. It is Dive.
At the bottom right, we have the Q-Gen of Alpha XI. We just did a cheeky Dave test, very Dave tested build. They've done that to me so many times, it's like got me tilted. For a while, I got really tilted by that. That fake, like,
yeah,
non...
DTs can be pretty tilting.
No, I mean, he always built some, the shrines outside of his base.
Yeah, well, you have to search for those tells. The fact that there was, you know, stalkers, like, you know, a large number of stalkers, but no aggression, that sort of thing. Yeah, there's a couple of tells you could look for. I don't think he was able to scout the tech in time at all, so he assumed something was proxied, and, yeah, quite likely he got a bit of a tip-off, so he went for that immediate observer and Oracle, but they weren't quite out in time. It's like, I thought Dive was going to try and go for the block there on the gateway, block him from completing that proper wall off. That would have been a pain.
Double gate and double gas, you know, from both players.
See, yeah, that's so standard Protoss openings. But yeah, anything you can do to tilt your opponent, you know, especially in mirror matchups, is great because, you know, essentially you've got almost the exact same opener. You know, well, in the meta with PvP up to this point, it is pretty much, you know, I mean, you can go for an early Nexus and cut one gate, but that's less common. It's pretty hard to hold from an attack. So here we go. We have Kyogen actually proxying
another
a gate
proxy
this time.
Midway into the map.
So now that warp in should be able to, if you take a look at where the proxy is, he should be able to warp in just to the north of that on the low ground. He's in the range of that pylon. So we've got two stalkers going out from both sides right now. And yeah, I guess we're probably going to see some more stalkers be warped in on the other side, and a bit of an aggressive opening or aggressive push from Kyogen. So the Robo is the tech choice for Dive. See that bin just placed down now. Oh, okay, we've got a scout for proxy here, but Dive not going to see it because it's up on the high ground. Kyogen also having a little bit of a look around, just making sure he's got no proxies around his base. Dive sending two stalkers out now across the other side of the map to put a little bit of pressure on.
Looking for proxies desperately. I know the feeling.
Yeah,
I know the feeling.
Both players search for proxies. Now, warp gate almost complete, so it'll be interesting to see exactly what Kyogen intends to do. Nice pullback micro there. Kyogen
getting
surround. Oh, misclick on that first stalker. Or not misclick, sorry. It was a...
Will he lose?
The stalker was... It was no, he didn't. It was rallied to the other
stalker.
Lose one.
Ouch. Now it's
5-3
stalkers.
The gateway was rallied to his
other
stalkers, so
it
ran past the enemy stalker.
This is quite bad.
Okay, now I'm curious to see why Kyogen actually he's spawning in more stalkers from his gateway rather than using the warp in. He does have the advantage right now in the numbers, although more stalkers have been warped in, he's not going to be able to hold this position right now. He has to back down or he will lose more stalkers.
Defender's advantage?
Yep, that ramp there, and that wall with the Immortal coming out now. He's definitely out right in time. He's going to warp in a few more stalkers just down here at his proxy location.
No Immortals from Orange.
Alright, here we go here.
This one Immortal is going to work.
He's on move command, not attack command.
Oh no.
He's still in the lead in this little fight here, but there is another Immortal on its way out at the moment. It looks like Dive is going to hold this for now. There is another two more stalkers for Kyogen on the way up. The Immortal and these few stalkers at the top of the ramp going to hold. But he definitely needs to leave this pylon down on the low ground at the moment. He cannot save that. Now, this ramp right now, probably impenetrable. He needs a prism or some more to get up there. I'd really like to see Dive go for a couple of sentries, or at least one here, to block the stalkers down, or trap a couple of them above the ramp.
Any good reason why he canceled that battery?
He probably because
he just need him
he
more.
Noticed that Kyogen's backing up because he can't push up here with Stalkers alone, and he knows that Kyogen knows that. Now, unfortunately, he has to make a choice here. The Immortal should be left at the ramp to keep Stalkers back, with a couple of Stalkers sent to the natural to defend his probes. So he's making the correct moves here, splitting his army up appropriately.
Five probes has gone down. Six.
Yeah, a few probes can be lost.
I believe that was quite worth it.
Yeah, but during this time, we've got Kyogen actually expanding. So Kyogen has that second, that first expansion actually up and ready, slowly but surely saturating it. But now he has to answer to these two Immortals. So now Dive actually does have a scary army here. You can see Kyogen actually dropping a shield battery right now. He doesn't have a lot at home, he does have an Immortal about to pop, but if Dive was going to have a chance to win, I feel like he probably should have gone for it. Kyogen actually has two Adepts in the main right now. It's actually not a wall. I think he thought that there was a gap. There was no gap there, but
those
Adepts going to get right through. And one Adept going to go down, and the other one going to get out.
Five.
That Adept is stuck in his base, and he doesn't... Okay, he knows now.
That's 13 workers killed so far, and only on one base.
We definitely have the Kyogen at the economic lead right now. But, Dive's definitely lost his opportunity to go for that early attack. So, yep, he's dropped down a Robo Bay. It looks like his only chance to win right now is going to be with a huge disruptor shot. Alright, both players silent down a little bit, trying to macro up, except for Dive, just going to go straight out with a Prism. He's got his three Immortals, a number of Stalkers. Going to be looking to attack soon. He's not going to expand. He knows that the only way to win now is to go for a big one-base attack.
Desperate.
Although, he's waiting for the Prism to finish, but he didn't time it great. I'd say that Prism is now blocking.
Observer sees his move out.
Yeah, well, okay, he's going to go for it, and the Prism is going to catch up, but I would have thought he was going to wait for a Disruptor. That's why he went for the Robo Bay.
Three Immortals, but there's a little much here, and he's got Shield Battery.
See, now the biggest problem is not the biggest problem, I'd say, but the Zealots do become annoying in PvP.
This Prism finally sees the Proxy, the bane of his existence.
Yep. And now the question is, did Kyogen spot it flying over? I don't think he did. He's warping in a couple of Adepts now to go and do some more harass. But this attack is coming up now. We've got three Immortals. Okay, it's been spotted by this hallucinated sentry.
This is a little much.
So we got a big attack coming up here. We see Kyogen splitting his army spreading them apart to get the better concave. There's just not going to be enough here for Dive right now. Three Immortals. Very good force field
trapping.
Recall pushed through. I think this that was the only chance to actually get the damage done. And we're going to see Kyogen go across the map and attempt to destroy his opponent right now.
How did he get some adepts in there? Where did they come in? Just walk right in?
Yeah, I must have missed those as well. I'm looking at this Prism up here by the Kyogen and sending it in. He's got two Immortals in that Prism, and Dive has nothing in his main to actually defend that right now. He needs a couple of Stalkers. Usually in PvP, especially by this time, you want two Stalkers in the main to stop that Prism from dropping or warping in.
Okay, and this is gonna be bad.
Bit of damage. He's gonna go for that Robo Bay, focus firing it down. That goes down, there's not going to be any more disruptors coming out.
And these Immortals.
See, what I'd like to see is the Stalkers on the low ground right now going out towards his third to trap that warp prism. That's what he needs to be doing. There we go. Okay, he knows now that's what he has to do. So the army going to go. No, he's still not going to move them.
Just doesn't have enough, maybe. Oh no, he does have enough.
Yeah, okay, he needs to move these stalkers in range to intercept this warp prism, otherwise it's going to keep wreaking havoc in his base.
Perhaps now?
Okay, going to go for the drop. Oh. No, I would love to see this prism be picked off, but now what I'm surprised to see, off the model,
there you go.
Two immortals down now. So what you'll often see at the pro scene, what they will do is they will immediately drop both immortals and recall them as soon as that happens, so that the prism goes down and the immortals do not. That's a large investment loss there. But we still see a very strong and scary army by Kyogen, full of charge lots as well. They're going to be very hard. That's probably the hardest thing to hit with disruptors are, in fact, charge lots. Well, I mean, you might... Do you ever watch M Canning stream?
I do not. I need to watch more high-level players.
Yeah, I was going to say, you watch M Canning stream, he does not make disruptors look hard, but there is a lot of micro and targeting involved in them. It's not easy to use. Sorry, they are not easy to use.
Yeah, I'm just starting to watch higher level games.
You'll learn a lot. Yeah.
I never really got into what before.
That's where you get a lot of Terran players saying, or not necessarily, not ones up at the top, just Terran players all over the place saying, you know, that they don't like disruptors, they think they're overpowered. But again, you know, they seem like they're the best unit in the world when they're used against you. But they're pretty hard to use. In PvP, not as much. You know, they're easy to get hits on Stalkers, Archons, and Stalkers, Archons, and Immortals, but not easy to hit charge lots with, especially if you don't want to kill your own units at the same time.
This prism warp out.
Oh, we're looking at a double disruptor.
Yeah, if he can get it on.
If only Dive knew that his opponent was right there, he could get a few good
shots and maybe he would have survived this.
Now, you can see that Kyogen going for a direct counter here with Phoenixes. So as soon as those disruptors fire, he just uses up his lifts on them, and yeah, he cancels it. Oh,
that's a massive hit, but
going down, nice big hit.
Might not matter.
That's what I'm saying. He can do all the economic damage in the world, but he cannot stop the army on his doorstep. Good force fields, not going to do a lot against the Archons. Recalls the prism with the disruptors in it. It's going to go down pretty quick if he hasn't dropped them. Does drop the disruptors. They're going to get lifted straight away though. Nice lifts. Very well played by Kyogen. GG is called.
Ouch.
And the series is taken 2-0 by Kyogen. Very nice PvP play. Very nice.
Yes, he has not had not much we put up a fight so far. Hoping some other players will.
Yeah, so there we go. That's I guess that concludes our three series for today, does it not? We had two PVZs and a PVP. Do we have any Terran players in this tournament?
We have Rendezvous. He's a Terran. And
okay.
I'm not sure about the other guys, what they are. But let me look it up. Let me look it up right now. Actually, did ask them to post what they got here. League and race. Okay. Captain Canuck, I just put him in. He's a 3,800 Protoss. Star Fox is a 3,900 Protoss. Ghost is a 4,200 Protoss.
Sounds like we got a lot of Protoss in our lineup.
This is a Protoss heavy tournament, apparently. It's going to be a lot of PvPs, apparently. It's nothing but Protoss, apparently. Why is there nothing but Protoss? More Protoss on your way. Yeah. Any closing words? Hello? I guess I'll just put up a roar. Kyogen's roar. And that's that. I guess that we will conclude this episode of High Cup Episode 2. And Happy New Year's. I'm gonna go get drunk. Now, is it New Year's done? Is there any New Year over there?
Sorry, can you repeat that? I was, I couldn't hear you.
Is it already the New Year's over there? New Year?
Yes, we're at 2:30 in the afternoon
ahead, right?
In Melbourne, Australia.
Okay.
But yeah, guys, so that's, I don't think we have any more planned for today's stream. Is that correct?
We do not. Hopefully,
all right,
next
year
we will have some.
Next
this
year.
This year for you. Well,
this year for
you.
This year for me. Maybe just tomorrow for me.
Yeah.
But yeah, guys, thanks for tuning in. We'll have some more games for you tomorrow. Please follow if you enjoy. And yeah, that will be all for today. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, everyone. And enjoy some music. And have a happy new year for some of you. And already happy new year for other people.
¡Suscríbete al canal!